Bruce, Bruce, back in the city. What's up, homie?
What's cracking, baby?
How you been?
Man, everything is absolutely stupendous. Did you hear me use that word?
Stupendous.
Now, I can't spell it, but I know how to use it, man. You know what I'm saying? Along with my man, Bryson Brown, next to me, man.
Yes, all the way from Texas,
what's up?
Right?
Texas and a half, man.
What part of Texas, man?
I'm from Austin, bro.
Okay, okay.
Yeah,
you know, the capital.
Yeah. The capital.
Y'all, get it in Austin, man.
Yeah, yeah, we do a little something. It's growing.
Oh, man.
Now, that's what, now, I only flew into Austin.
Okay.
And then, you know, I've been to Dallas and Houston and Killeen. But I
you got
to
come out there, South by Southwest. All,
yes,
you know,
I
all
hear,
the little festivals,
lit.
Man.
Yeah, it ain't country's a mugging off. Man, about country. About country.
We city country, bro.
Let me tell you something.
We city
when you
country.
Go down the street and you see a sofa on the front porch,
right.
And somebody done put a chain on it and made a swing sofa out of it, you in the country, baby. You know what I'm saying? And I get it. My granddaddy, you know, my old folks didn't throw away nothing. My granddaddy and grandma bought a new sofa. My granddaddy said, now what we going to do with that old sofa? We going
to
put it
right
on the front porch.
They done
put a chain on it, man. Right. Swing sofa.
Eight
I'm swinging
on the patio.
In that bad
boy.
They about to cave to seal it in. It's so heavy.
Yeah.
Because, you know, like grandma and granddad, you ever notice they cover on the bed be real heavy?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Thick. Like, I mean, you can't move. You're in one spot. You can't help but go to sleep.
And they ain't turn on no AC.
Hey, look
you
at it.
Like,
if you having a dream running, you got a dream running from the devil, you ain't getting away with that cover. That cover going to keep you down. You be paced right. Like a
tie you down, bro.
That cover so heavy because your grandmama done crocheted by three of them blankets. She done crocheted. You know, she do that in the house on her spare time.
Right.
You know, that's an old word, crochet.
Crochet.
And I wonder, who's more countryer? Is it Georgia? Is it Texas? Is it Arkansas?
Arkansas because won all day.
Well, listen, I was in Arkansas. I saw a house on three bricks.
Yeah, Arkansas.
Yes, sir.
All day,
you can
man.
See right
three
up under.
Three bricks.
Right. And they had a
on
basement.
On my way to the casino.
Well, you can say,
and they had a basement.
Atlanta, the city. Atlanta ain't really country.
Now,
like
Atlanta,
Georgia.
Like people think,
it
like
ain't
people
really
think
like
Birmingham is country. Birmingham is not country. I mean, it's more city. And I don't see some country stuff in New York.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You
yeah.
go to like.
We just in Hartford.
Like go to, not in Manhattan, not Brooklyn, nothing like that, but you go to these little, like Rochester,
yeah, the state of New York.
Oh,
yeah,
my
you get
goodness.
Oh yeah,
country. I seen
yeah,
dude
Buffalo.
Saying, I love her and I love him. Yeah, now wait a minute, y'all 40-something years old.
Still dressed.
You still wearing a dress? Y'all dressed like that? I didn't want to go up and grab the lady by the show and just shake her for about 30 minutes. You know what I'm saying? You don't wear that like that. You, that's just like any brother. Is 25 and older with a mohawk, you need to be slapped in the face. 25 and back, you're
you know,
okay.
Wait. Who still got a mohawk? Help me out.
Play basketball?
No, comedian.
Wait a minute. Don't tell me that. I'm going to get him.
Yeah.
Huh?
Not Wayans.
He got one.
Marley,
He just left here. I can't think his name.
Deion Cole?
No, not Deion. Not Deion. Anyway, I get to it.
Yeah. If you're 25 and older with a mohawk, you need to be hit dead in your chest. If you 49 with a mohawk, talking about what's happening, it ain't that mohawk. You understand what I'm saying? Some things you just don't do, man. You have to let go.
Some things you just got to let go.
Like my granddad used to pull his pants leg up every time he sit down. See, old men don't do that no more. How you doing? Ain't everybody getting along. He pulled them pants up and sit down.
Yeah, let that knee,
I never
that
knew why they did
that.
I never knew why they did
that. Or when they get out the chair like this, they got to do this.
Yes, sir.
What's that?
They got a rock.
And, you know, old men use old words. He say, you know, I was out there at the job. I had a picket line, you know. And the mother guys folded me down with me. They sat there and didn't say not one mumbling word. Not one mumbling word. My granddaddy say he was so quiet, you can hear a rat licking Lloyd.
Right.
Now, that's quiet. That's quiet, doc.
How the grandkids, man?
Man, they good, man. Yeah. You know, one arm out of control. He do the mumble talk to me. I had to hit him in his chest.
The what talk?
The mumble. You know, they mumble around. You know, I take him, you know, around here last Christmas, get him a new iPhone. You know what I'm saying? Something I don't have to do. But I'm doing it because young kids got the phone.
Yeah.
So I talked to him. I said, we at the AT&T store. You know what I'm saying? And I said, hey, man, which phone you like right here? I said, who you talking to? Open your mouth. You can say everything else. I said, mumble one more time.
It's over.
And you're going to see a dentist. You're going to make him rich. I'm telling you. I don't play. His mama said, T, he don't play.
Yeah.
See, I don't play with him. You know what I'm saying? When I say something to you, talk to me.
Yeah.
But open your mouth and see what happens. I get this crowbar and beat you to death. You know what I'm saying? So, but the other ones are cool. But this one here, you know, he smelling himself.
Yeah,
thank you, all that, you know. I went and took him shopping, bought him new clothes and everything. 2 hours later, mama called me. He done got his shoes took and everything. I said, he'll be all right. He'll be all right.
He got his shoes taken.
I'm not finna run to his rescue. You understand what I'm saying? Right. Learn to keep your mouth closed.
Right.
Yep. I done run their mouth. See, you know, these young boys don't play. I don't even mess with the young boy. One told me to move my car, and it was in front of my house. I said, wait a minute. Where you want me to put it then? So I couldn't talk too bad, so I got to have my pistol. If I had my pistol, right. I'd put that pistol on him.
You just driving around the neighborhood.
I said, no, where you want me to, where you want me to park? He said, park it anywhere other than there. And this is my house.
Right.
So, you know.
Yeah, and then grandkids will get you, too.
Yeah, they get you.
They get you, man.
Men come at you, look at you, the more pretty brown eyes.
Yeah, yeah.
Granddad, you know, they got a big thing at the school. It costs $7,000. Get girl, I will hit you and choke you to death. I will Ike Turner slap you and hit a death.
You say Ike Turner slap you.
You know Ike Turner will play. Ike Turner slap you to death.
You play at the Improv this weekend. We got two tonight.
Two tomorrow and one Sunday so far. They might try to have one, but hey, man, they need to get a ticket because every time I come, I can't lie.
Yeah.
It's love every single time. I don't care if I'm at the theater, I'm at the comedy club. People come out. Because I'm going to tell you, it ain't nothing to do here. I've been here. Everybody's depressed. Everybody. The paper man throwing papers. How you doing? Yeah. Leave it alone. You know what? I've been throwing paper for 40 years. I don't need to hear this. You know what I'm saying?
Hard too, huh?
You know, ain't got nothing but bars and restaurants here. You're going to eat and you're going to get drunk and clean.
Yeah, that's it. Now we get the Browns.
You better believe it. The Browns trying to come back.
Now, get
the
Browns. We got the Browns.
But 2 years ago.
Yeah, but two years ago,
they had the
Reds. Had them bags on their face. Had them bags on the face.
I'm talking about they had that Kool-Aid face. Well, they were showing up like they did. Hey, they say, we got a game this Saturday. You playing. They didn't know they were supposed to practice.
It was like a championship last night.
You right downtown.
They had the street blocked off and everything. Come this way, please. This way. Police directed traffic. Good God Almighty.
Yeah, it was full downtown last night.
Bro. Yeah,
man. You know, but Cleveland is, you know, it's a good game town. Basketball.
Yeah.
Baseball, football. You know, LeBron left. Everybody got mad. You know what I'm saying?
Well, not too much.
People
got
to understand. LeBron's got to do what he got to do for his family.
Yeah,
you got to understand the business part of it. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Man, folks don't want to hear that.
He proved his point here.
Yeah,
he proved it. He came back and proved himself.
You think he'll get a ring down in L.A. now?
Yeah, if somebody called him. Yeah. Look, somebody called him on phone. No, he probably get a ring, man. You know, LeBron's LeBron, man. I mean, I'm a LeBron James fan, so don't quote me. I am a true fan.
Yeah.
So I met him when he was 17.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? I'm a true fan here. Yeah. So I think if he got the right people with him, you know, LeBron's will make it happen.
Yeah.
You know, he got to do with a unibrow, you know.
Say what?
It was to do with the unibrow, eyebrow, me. His eyebrow, me. That mean he crazy as a mother. He'd do anything LeBron say. But I did think Kawhi was going to go to the Lakers. He faked it about that.
Man, dude, wasn't that a trip? He went to meet, talking about, I need to meet Magic.
He faked him out. But you know what? This is what I think about
he
Toronto.
He did a whole.
You know, he went to Toronto, and he won a championship.
Yeah.
But this is my personal opinion. I don't care what people feel about it or what they think about it. Drake needs to stay off the court.
Drake needed.
He will probably push
Why
him out of
is there. He sitting down with the team? I actually saw him writing on the board with the coach. He was like, no, we need to run this play here, run that play. Drake, stay off. Come on, man.
Hold on.
931ZAK. We hanging out with Bruce, Sam Silk Show, while you get your work going tonight, tomorrow, and on Sunday. Bruce is there doing his thing. Also, Bryson Brown is in the building all the way from Texas.
Yeah.
And it's going to be funny than the Mickey Ficky. A lot of people are getting into the weed business, man. Arizona iced tea creators are soon to be pushing out weed-infused products.
Who's this, iced tea?
Yeah, Arizona iced tea.
Oh, but look. You know, I talked to Mike Tyson. He said he got 600 acres in California.
Yeah.
I said, how it's doing? It's doing swell.
You know what I'm saying?
That boy got a whole weed ranch.
So, you know, he got a whole farm.
He got a whole ranch.
Yeah, he got a whole farm.
Beyonce daddy, he's selling it now.
I went and walked on the farm, and I don't even smoke, and I got high. I said, Bruce, what's wrong? I said, ain't nothing but a party, baby.
Adrian Bronner says that he's retiring, and he wants to know how it feels to snort a line and shoot some heroin.
He want to what now?
like you get beat up like that.
Like Otis Sal Martin, you know, Otis, you want to run that by me one more time?
I'm like, hold on, what?
Yeah. Yeah, you
just wants some attention.
You know, I just don't know what's up with black people today, man. You know, we used to be real basic and do our thing. You know, we retire, go play golf, you know, wash our cars.
Yeah.
Now they want to do some stuff that we have never heard of in our life. Right. Black people, come on back. It ain't too late. Come on back.
Come on back.
Come on back.
Bring it, ain't it on back.
Right. Bring it on back. You know, when I retire, and when I retire, I probably won't retire. I'm going to continue to do something. Because people that retire and sit down, there's two things happen to them. They get sick or they die.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not going to do neither one of them. Yeah. So I'm going to continue to do something. If I start back stripping,
you're going to find something to do.
I'll just be an old stripper. Old player on stage, 81.
You're
going
to find something to do.
Give it up for old school. I'll probably be playing Bobby Blue player. I'm sorry.
Slow.
I'm sorry. This stripping.
Yeah, for we got more coming up, man. The church announcements. Reverend Tribble, he wants to talk to you.
So yeah, Reverend Tribble.
If he can get you out this weekend while you're in town.
Okay.
So we talk to Reverend Tribble coming up on the other side. The Sam Sim Show on 931 ZAK with Bruce Bruce.
Ain't nobody hotter.
Hey, Reverend, how are you?
Hello there, Brother Sam, Brother Sam, Brother Sam.
Sister yes.
Kenya,
yes.
And I believe you have one of my favorite people, Brother Bruce Bruce.
Yes.
Hey, Pastor, how you doing?
Yes, Reverend.
Amen.
Amen.
Bruce, amen. Amen. It's so wonderful to see you. Now, you at the Improv.
Yes, sir.
And that starts tonight, I do believe.
Tonight, Saturday and Sunday. Monday, yeah. I am out like 8 tracks.
Yeah.
Amen.
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 Hey, Reb, I got to ask you something, though, before you get started.
Yeah, amen. Please, go ahead, brother.
Listen, you know, I go to church every Sunday, and they've been taking up an offering for the kids in Haiti, and I went to Haiti, and they ain't saw none of that money.
Ain't seen a dime.
I ain't seen a penny of it. So tell me
what's
happening.
That's why I take up offerings for only the children in our neighborhood.
Yes, sir.
Well, Reverend. That's all right, Pastor.
We're glad you're doing it.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, well, we want to see you come out, Brother Bruce.
I'm going to come
if
out.
If you can, we do. We want to see if Brother Bruce can come out for our youth day.
Let me tell you.
This weekend.
I'll come see you. Man.
And the wife and I are going to present you with our own personal Griff, which is a very lovely Andy Griffith bathrobe and short set.
I'll take it. I'll take it. You know, you done read my mind, Reverend.
Amen. 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 So we want you to come out for that.
Now, look, but of now, course, if I get Brother Bruce, shouting, if I get to shouting, don't stop me. Let him use me.
No. None of ours is getting your way. No, amen. Amen. But we're so glad that you're here. But you know, Brother Sam and Sister Trina and everybody, allow me an opportunity to do the announcements of the Old New True Light Burning Bush Amy Pentecostal Missionary Fellowship Baptist Temple
COG. Yes, sir.
And anything you hear that you'd like to participate in, please feel free to do so. Now, we've been blessed, Brother Bruce and Brother Sam and Sister Kenya. We have another sponsor.
All right.
We're being sponsored this week by Wanda Superfood Soul Food Restaurant and Catering.
All right.
Yes, big or small, Wanda Soul Food and Catering has it all. This week's special is the pedicured pig's feet. You can get your choice, amen, of pig's feet with French tips, solid color, or glittery nails.
And they've been pedicured.
So if you want good food, wander into Wanders.
So
three
been,
locations
they,
to serve pedicured. You, and especially you.
We coming, Reb. We want that pedicure pig feet.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, just to let you know, this Sunday is the pastor's anniversary.
Okay.
I'm not trying to sound pushy, but let's step up our game a little bit when it comes to the gift giving. I hate to complain about last year's gift, but it's nothing that me and the First Lady can do with a slip and slide. I want everybody to step up your game just a little bit.
Slip and slide.
You know, Pastor, I went to anniversary of the church last Sunday, and the pastor said
amen.
They can keep all the cakes and pies. He needs a little bit more money.
Amen.
So all the money he spent on the cakes and pies, just keep the money and send it to the pastor. Ain't that right?
Hold down that cholesterol.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Amen. Now, we have just a few cancellations. The Marshawn Lynch How to Inspire Impressionable Children seminar has been canceled. Also, Also, the Jeffrey Epstein R. Kelly Young Girls Empowerment Retreatment Camp. With special guest,
that would have been a good
Olympic
one.
Gymnast Larry Nassar has also permanently been canceled.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, the organization known as Women with Husbands That Resemble Talk Show Host Wendy Williams will meet tonight in Meeting Room 3A.
3A.
That's
3A.
Meeting Room 3A. Not to be confused with 3B.
Okay.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, we'd like to apologize. I believe it is. Yes, I was just handed something, Brother Sam. But anyway, I'll read this first. We'd like to apologize to everyone for the fight that occurred during service last Sunday.
Yeah,
the incident happened when Brother Otis Green, who had just been freshly released from prison, jumped on one of our male ushers during the offering.
Why?
Now, Brother Green said that he hopes that the church will forgive him because he had been in that life, and said that when he saw that usher walk up to him with that hand behind his back, he had to go into action. Had to make sure that something's done about that. And last but not least, this was just handed to me, Brother Sam. Funeral services for Mother Daisy Bell Howard will be held this Thursday night at the church. I'm sorry, it just got to me a moment. Sister Howard, who was 101, suffered from eyelash infection, diabetes, high blood pressure, earlobe fungus, asthmatic toe jam, elbow rash, chronic ingrown hairs of the lower lip. But she survived all that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
She actually died from choking to death after her 22-year-old great-grandbaby talked her into taking the Amber Rose cucumber challenge.
Goodbye, Rabbit.
Just move, brother.